So the bell was at the entrance to the embassy, which is there. And the bell would tell the ambassador who was coming, like someone from the Sultan's court, the number of times they went. And in the 1820s, the priest here, who was an Irishman, asked, could they have the bell ringing before the church service? And they asked the Sultan if that was acceptable. He said yes. So 40 years before the rest of the Ottoman Empire, this chapel had the bell ringing for Sunday service.
Oh.
Yeah. Now, it's just a very simple bell, but it's originally the embassy bell, and I'm not supposed to ring it. Actually. So that disappeared after the bomb, and they were reconfiguring the building. That bell disappeared. And the consul general's widow, who's a friend of mine, she said, Ian, where's the bell? I said, oh, I never remember. I don't know what happened. And they were going to throw it out. Wow. So she rescued it. And then we built a little place to put it there.
Wow, this bell is from 1820.
Oh, yeah, easily. Before the 1820s. It was already in use on this site.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
They've been on this, there's been a chapel on this site since the 1600s.
Father, is it okay for you filming here around when you are talking and things?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Wow.
That's white wine.
I bought that in a back street in Damascus. It's a very nice man, sold that to
me. So this is a little bit. Now, I think this was in St. Helena's originally, in Christ.
The ivories are all here.
These are cobbler, swell to grape, grape to pebble.
Because it's not tuned, of course. Did we come that far while checking the palette?
Why? We don't know. We will see.
now. Okay, this is connected.
I am not feeling good at all.
I know. Sorry for you.
Yes! Finished.
Well, okay. I'll keep connecting. So, yeah, I'll see.
Take a breath.
Let's hear this. If the organ is too loud, tell me.
Pitch down.
How is it? Can you hear her?
Yes.
Perfect.